The next item on the agenda is the approval of corrections of the minutes. The board meeting that was held on June 13, 2017. Are there any corrections to the minutes?
Yes, sir. Public education, that needs to be corrected. I said that trustee Denise Meyer said that there would be a great asset to the village board.
What needs to be corrected?
What I said. What's reading says trustee Denise Bonner said that it was a great service. No, I said it will be a great served asset to the village of Burnham. Also, under Parks and Recreation, it says trustee Denise Bonner, the community center training to the volunteers and community center works on the fire extinguishers and possibly go around with smoke detectors. What I said was to have training to the volunteers and community center workers on use of the fire extinguishers and possibly go around and check the smoke detectors. Also, for presentation and
It's on the recorder.
Also, for presentation of petitions, it says trustee Denise Bonner stated that she is looking forward to the two accommodations of the two officers. I said that I'm looking forward to reading the accommodation for the two officers.
And also in the minutes, Ms. Andrew Dunn had asked a question about the bridge. It was a question recorded that the bridge was opened on June 26th, when in fact it was opened June 2nd. Did you make that change as well? And Ms. Jackie Crosby recorded that the berry tree was dropping berries on the parkway, and in fact dropping berries on the sidewalk. Any other corrections? Okay, I will ask for a motion to approve the minutes with the corrections made.
I make a motion to approve the minutes with the corrections made.
Have a motion on the floor by trustee Clint Wilson, and a second.
I second the motion.
Clerk, take a roll.
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner?
Yes.
Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Greer?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Trustee Clayton?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. The motion approved, the minutes approved. Thank you. Before the citizens speak, before we open the meeting to the public, if you have anything to state to the board, if you will stand up and give your name, you will be speaking to the board. Please keep your comments in for 3 minutes, please. 3 minutes. At this time, I will ask for a motion to open the meeting to the public.
Motion to open the meeting to the public.
The motion on the floor by trustee Garcia. We need a second.
I second.
Second by trustee Gibbs.
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner?
Yes.
Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Greer?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Our motion passes. We'll start with this row, the second row here. The row, do you have anything?
Yes.
The rest, do you have anything?
Yeah, is this where you ask questions? So, I'm Malika Reyes. I'm not always able to see to come to the meetings, so I was wondering, I see it's being videoed. Is it accessible online? Or?
I mean, that's a private person that's doing that. It doesn't have it.
Oh, okay. So we don't videotape it, so we just videotape it?
Well, I think that's something we definitely put on the agenda for the next meeting.
No.
I videotaped him, it's darn right, thank you, Mr. Bonner. Thank you for speaking up.
Does anybody have any other questions? And I will say for the record, you know, there are some towns that do have meetings recorded, and they are marked there. You're not gonna have that. Now, if anybody wants to record, that's not gonna be you, it's a public meeting, there's nothing against the law to do that. Village of Burnham, it's not gonna.
Andrew Johnson, did you say the address or not?
No, you don't have to.
Okay, Andrew Johnson, I just wanted to pass along if you get a chance. I really appreciate that bridge finishing up. I've used it any number of times since it's been done. And it's very, very nice. If you get a chance, pass it along. I really appreciate you getting that bridge done.
All right, thank you. Are there any other public comments?
Hey, Mr. Romero, thank you for your time. I've been in this town now roughly more than 12 years. And I believe I came to one of these meetings many years ago. I'm not certain, I've not seen towns between now and what that looks like. But I'd certainly like to inquire where the, I know that alley's being paved in different blocks of the neighborhood. Again, I'm not here every day, so I'm not looking at it, I'm not certain where those are. But I have seen pictures of multiple areas. And I just want to know where we stand with that and where our towns stand on that. Because, you know, many of us have, you know, make expenses and make sacrifices for our vehicles. And a fixed flat tires nowadays is very expensive. For mine, it's about $120 to get all our tires. I just want to know where we're at with paving the alleys.
Well, that's a very good question. And any of the alleys that you have seen paved in Burnham, they already had asphalt in them.
Yep.
They made a hole there, and we repaired them.
Now,
that one alley down by 139th and Saginaw, that was done by Mr. Ball. That was not done by Village of Burnham.
Yeah, I asked this because last winter I spent $900 on my vehicle because I hit a hole in my alley. And so, again, many of us make sacrifices to get our vehicles.
Well,
so we just want to know where those updates are.
Well, the Village of Burnham cannot afford to pave the alleys, and so, you know, I'm not gonna promise you that we can do that.
Yeah.
And we can only, when we pave the street, it would take about $30,000 per block to do the street. And we do that for the city, we can only do that, so, you know, so it would be very, very difficult for us to pave that. And then if we did that,
I'm certainly very familiar with the cost of the manufacturing and I deal with this every day. But I did see you on the upgrade of a beautiful white page that you have up there with all the upgrades to the main bridge.
Right.
You know, maybe we can get that as part of the future or part of the.
And certainly if the money comes available, we can settle this.
I have a question. What's your name and where do you live?
My name is Manuel Romero. I live on the block of Green Bay, 142nd in Green Bay. Hopefully, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, I've lived here. Probably this great community. Well, I don't want to move anywhere.
And I think we took it aside. Well, we can't do nothing about that right now. Okay. Are there any other public comments? Are there any other public comments?
Yeah. I'm Debbie Zukowski. I live down on 38. My things with the new construction that's going on and all the damage that's going to our properties. I have a list of questions if you want to ask the contractor to get some answers.
Well, the chief and I, we had a meeting with the clerk and they gave us, you know, some comments. They were supposed to get it back to us, you know, so we could have a public community meeting. And as soon as they give us that name, we'll do that. But they did assure us that the banging and the vibration really should be done this week. But to specifically answer your question, that we have to get that from them.
Most of ours is they lowered the water table. How low did they lower it? And did they do soil testing? Determine how before the dewatering began, and what is it now? Because all our houses are built on sand, which is clay, when it's wet. They de-watered it, sucked all the water out of the ground, and that clay's gonna turn to sand. And when they stop de-watering, where is that void gonna go? It's gonna go back to sand.
Well, I believe that that process is complete now, but we will try to get you an answer to those questions. If you will give that to the chief, then we will, but it would come and, so hopefully they'll get it back to us soon by public.
You know, they're waking us up at 6 o'clock in the morning, dropping this, about the size of a car, and they drop it, compacted dirt.
I believe, don't quote me, but I believe they will be the last day for that. Now, they should be definitely concluding that this week.
But I got a crack in my garage floor.
And where's this at, Dave?
138.
At what?
Who?
138.
The whole 138th Street?
Yeah.
Nah, this street.
I have pictures of, my garage floor.
Did?
This is a second building.
The rail car, let's see.
This was.
Okay, are there any other public?
The south end of my ground floor, this is, you know, 2 days later.
I have a public comment.
And then, this is the north end, and this is 2 days later.
I'm not gonna be able to stand because I've got some knee problems, so if it's all right, I'd like to sit. My name's Gerald Hunter.
This is the crack in the side of my building.
The question I have is, who's in this room, Romero here, is this?
You know, are they gonna be, you know, are they gonna be responsible for this? Because my insurance will be in the cover.
The village will have to do that.
Find out.
From my understanding, a lot of it comes from block grant money. And east side of town, we make too much money, so no money will ever be spent on our side of town. But we'll notice some of the streets are, you might get a sidewalk repaired, or a little curb might be repaired, but there's no project for our streets to be resurfaced on that side of town. The money gets spent right around here, and right around another area of town. So Green Bay Avenue, some of these streets, your alley is probably gonna come far later, than that. Also, on the agenda.
First of all, what you.
It's my turn to talk. I got 3 minutes to talk, you can answer when I'm done, you're not gonna take my time. Then you can answer after I'm done, you're not gonna take my time. There's a Open Meetings Act, which means that the agenda of the village has to be posted, so everybody can read it 48 hours before every meeting. It gets posted up here, but you can't really see, it should be posted on Sunday night, majority of the time it gets posted on Monday, because the schedule don't allow for them to come and post it on Sunday. That's a violation of the Open Meeting Act, and that needs to be done. Also, it's supposed to be posted on our website. And it's not even on our website tonight, so that people at home can read what's on the agenda, maybe come to the meetings and see what's going on, never posted. I told you about it, and I told you I was gonna call the clerk's office, and I guess you just disregarded what I said, and you don't care about it. Well, it's a violation of the Open Meeting Act, and that shouldn't be done every week. And also, if you're gonna hire a human relations person to take care of the minimal employees here, why aren't you doing that, Ms. Chavez? Why does that need to be subcontracted out? It need to be subcontracted out exactly like our internet technology, other items, you guys are starting to outsource all these things, and you're letting go of village employees. Why aren't you taking care of that? Or when you hired your employees in the office, Mr. Mayor, why didn't you make sure those people were qualified to do those type of things? So you have to outsource it to other companies. Now I'm finished.
Okay, well, thank you. And let me say, as far as the streets go, the community block grant that you said about that, that is true. I mean, the east side of Burnham, I'm on the far side of the block grant. And it's where I live, no longer qualified for the block grant. And only through the east side of Torrance does qualify. But we also could use MFT funds for that, but just the fact that we don't have enough of them. But that still would be under consideration.
It's never been discussed in a meeting, I've never heard it in any of the board meetings.
I mean, that's true.
Right, that's because you hide these things, you don't tell, the citizens. You only tell them what you want them to hear.
And as far as the employees not doing certain things, we're gonna leave that alone, okay? We're gonna leave that alone.
I'd rather have you bring it up. Hey, do I know who I am? I was fired 2 weeks ago. All right, I was here for 16 years.
That's what most of the council meetings.
¿Alguien quería decir algo? ¿Que hable español y quiera decir algo?
I think.
Nosotros nomás
Nomás lo mismo de la...
Su nombre primero para que lo escriba ahí.
Juan Galván.
¿Y dónde vive?
138.
Número 38. ¿Y su pregunta?
Nada más por lo de la casa que también se nos está cuarteando todo. Es lo mismo que en la mañana tiembla muy, muy fuerte. Y yo no sé si irá a poder hacer algo, ¿no? ¿Quién sabe?
Está organizando una junta con los contratistas.
Cuando
sepa una fecha, se les va a avisar.
Ok, está bien.
A veces al último minuto nos dicen la fecha, pero se van a asegurar de que sepan.
Ok, está bien, gracias.
En la mañana, yo les puedo avisar, o no, si les puedo avisar, o de ahí mandamos para que sepan.
Ah, está bien, gracias.
¿Alguien más?
Is that it? Any other public comments? Any other public comments? I'll ask for a motion to close the meeting to the public.
Make a motion to close the meeting to the public.
As a motion for by trustee Claybrook, to close the meeting to the public, need a second.
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner?
Yes.
Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Yes.
Motion passed, meeting is not closed to the public. But that's one of the things that I was gonna say, is that we did have a chief, clerk did have a meeting with the builders, you know, for that project, or we had that a couple days ago, so we got some things cleared up. And like you said, the vibration should be done, it wasn't done in April, it definitely should be done by tomorrow, is what they told them. And once we get back, now the issue with the dust, like they put more trucks out there.
Well, they did put, I'm sorry, they did put, a water truck did go through there once, just in the last couple of days.
Okay.
Weathered it down.
Did they even try to make your burden to get there?
At this time, we will hear a report from the clerk.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Just want to remind everybody, stickers are on sale and they expire June 30th. Office is open Monday to Thursday, 9 to 5. Please bring in your vehicle registration to purchase your sticker. And we're open Friday, 9 to 7. So Friday's the last day. So if you haven't purchased it, please do. And it's $50 per passenger, and e-trucks are $70.
And thank you, clerk, for that report of public education, health, safety, and welfare. Trustee Graham.
Yes, good evening, everyone.
Good evening. Good evening.
Illinois Housing Authority, they have a housing development authority, has a home accessibility program. This is a program that's funded by the Illinois Housing Development Authority and is our homeowners to address long overdue accessibility issues that can affect the health and safety of their families. The grant is worth $25,000 in home modification, and the work can be performed by professional contractors. They can do things in your home like putting grab bars, accessible showers, cabinets, countertops, they can widen doors, etc., etc. After 5 years, if you would like to apply for the grant, here's application. After 5 years, the grant will be forgiven,
and you will not have to pay anything at all.
So if you'd like more information on this, I'd be more than happy to give you a copy after the meeting. And just want to remind you that their senior transportation schedule for seniors, rides are provided to major medical facilities within Thornton Township, as well as to the DeVito Renal Service, that's in Hammond, Governor's Highway Clinic in Homewood, South Suburban Hospital, Hazelcrest, Metro South in Blue Island, St. Margaret's Health Center, that's in Hammond, Hammond Clinic in Munster, and Community Hospital in Munster. And they also provide service to various shopping centers. So if you know of anyone that needs the service, I'll be more than happy to give you a copy after the meeting. Just want to remind you that South Suburban College has opened a new Latino Health Center. This is in response to the growing Latino community. And the center is located in the Counseling Center, room 2350. The mission of the center is to help Latinos achieve the dreams for education. So for more information, we have a number, that you can call to inquire. And they also provide interpretation help. Just to remind anyone that does not have a sign, that need a sign, please see me after the meeting. We're more than happy to give you one. If you would like to take one for your neighbors, feel free. If you have one, but you need a new one, feel free. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Gray, for that report and your information. Public Works and Building, Trustee Haybrook.
Good evening. I have a few things on the Public Works Department. A street sweeper was out around the town. You know, I witnessed it firsthand. The alleys were being graded. We had tree trimmers out, trimming trees. Also, the area around 143rd and Yates, where it was dark and, you know, it was kind of bad, like that unsafe, you know, unsafe environment. Public Works trimming trees and remove debris and stuff, you know, because it's a hiding place for, you know, like people, well, mostly kids or teenagers or older people drinking and stuff like that. So, you know, that was cleaned up. And also cleaned up a few vacant lots and cut grass around town. And I just want to wish everyone a happy and safe Independence Day.
Also at the 143rd and Yates, that was wind blew dead tree down on the vehicle program. I'm glad the resident didn't blame the front, but it was an act of God.
Right.
We have had people try to get us to pay for a vehicle when the wind destroyed it. That's not going to happen.
Okay, that's all I got for
you. The ordinance resolution and planning, Trustee Garcia.
The only thing I have is that place over on Burnham, Brad Press from Burger King, is looking really good. If they're picking up, the windows have gone up in the little strip mall. So we're getting closer to that.
And so, they should be looking at the engineer plan for the sewer and the water, but so around some half of it. Thank you, Trustee Garcia, tell you. Finance, Trustee
Cap. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Discussion of consideration of and taking action on approving the contract from Connor and Gallagher OneSource to handle our human resources. OneSource will implement human resource policies and handle all the human resources duties, including payroll. The proposal costs us a monthly fee of $2,275.
Yes. So, this person is supposed to take care of, this is an outsourced HR thing, right?
It's a company.
An outsourced HR company, and they're going to do payroll.
They're going to do payroll.
And timekeeping?
Timekeeping, they're going to create policies for the employees. They're going to document any disciplinary action of a third party. When an employee leaves, they'll actually do an exit interview with the employee and cover all the bases that needs to be done. Company, you know, would help us to be proactive. Having the policies and having that third party for the HR would show us, in addition to our current insurance carriers, or casualty insurance, that we're working on reducing any type of risk in regards to HR. And also, currently our family or our broker, or any carrier to even consider.
And this company also carries our workman's comp insurance also, right?
Actually, it's a different company for workman's comp. That's the college.
Previously, in the past meeting, it says that this company also insures our workman's comp.
No, we had to get a different company to do the workman's comp because the broker that we have for casualty wasn't able to get us our own. So it's a different company.
were not included in this budget.
So outsourcing for HR, you know, timekeeping and payroll, that's not our issue. Our issue is fairness and the human issue of fairness and transparency and ethics. Okay, that's our problem. How do we fix that? I don't know if this outside HR can fix that.
As I said, they would create the policies that need to be in place in order to do that.
Okay, are they going to tackle every single little issue of ethics and fairness that the problems that we have?
Well, some of the issues that we have is just a matter of fact of who eyes you're looking through as well as what is fair, what is not fair. Because, I mean, sometimes, I mean, there are people that's, I mean, just do whatever and they call them eyes, it is correct. I don't know.
It's an extra opinion, at least you get the third party.
Right.
Okay, but this is $2,000 extra per month that we have to pay. When, what do we pay Sue Racine for? A full-time administrative assistant that does payroll for the police department.
I mean, but that's going to be.
I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor, I have to go. What do we have?
Well, I'm in charge of the meeting, go ahead.
What do we have? We went from one full-time to one part-time in the front office to three full-time.
Yeah, that's not true.
It's true.
So my question is.
The office has always had.
No.
You know, we had Judy and we had Nancy. Judy was part-time treasurer and Nancy was full-time.
Well, that, I mean, that is enough work here in the office for the people to do. And we're going to go ahead and proceed with this, so you know, whatever position you take.
Okay, so as far as the discussion and consideration, I say that we table this for further discussion.
No, we're not going to table, we're going to go ahead and see, but this needs to go into effect July 1st. So I will ask for a motion.
I ask, what's the rush, Mayor?
I have stated that we're going to put this into effect July 1st, it needs to be, and I ask for a motion to.
Okay, so also, according to Illinois policy, and after the whole scandal with over half a million being stolen, okay, they said we're one of the worst municipalities as far as transparency and ethics. Okay, so instead of responding to that and becoming more transparent and becoming working to a better government, what we did was we shut it down on Wednesday.
Now that's nothing to you. No, that didn't have anything to do.
I understand, but we have to work towards a better government.
I mean, there was a lot of things going on at that time, and we had more important things to do than to be concerned about the website at that time.
3 years ago.
So shut it down.
That's what it was.
3 years.
Does anybody have another question? I'll ask for a motion.
3 years.
I should do that anyway.
Yeah, go ahead, I'm sorry.
So I'd like to make a motion to approve the contract from Connor Gallagher OneSource to handle our human resources.
You're a traitor too. You're
the OneSource to implement human resources policies and handle all the human resources duties, including the payroll. The proposal cost is a monthly fee of $2,275.
And thank you. There's a motion on the floor by Trustee Cap. We need a second.
Second.
No.
Can I take the roll, please?
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner?
No.
Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Greer?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Trustee
Clayton? Yes. Okay, thank you. Motion passed. Public utilities, Trustee Richardson, you take that, please.
Good afternoon and good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Discussion of, consideration of, and taking action to approve or not approve the hire of Andre Lewis as a temporary certified operator of the pump station for the amount of $800 on a monthly basis.
Any questions or comments about that?
Yes. Is he certified?
Did you read the agenda?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
Do we have his resume?
He said on that he's certified. Yes, he is.
Do we have his resume?
Yes, we have his resume.
Okay.
And you'll get it.
And will he also answer the alarm calls?
Well, we haven't had any alarm call, but yes, that'll be taken care of.
Well, my question is.
That's going to be addressed. We really not going to debate it.
Okay. Point of order, sir. My question.
For the record, I'm in charge of the meeting. I conduct the meeting.
Okay, sir. Okay. Point of order.
Okay.
Wow.
So, I'm in charge of the meeting.
Okay, thank you. So my question is, okay.
We don't have money to do
all
this.
We get water alarms here at the dispatcher.
Officer?
And And according to a memo that we received at the last minute meeting on May 9th, it says that Burnham Police will be dispatched 24/7 from Dalton Blood's dispatch center.
No, like a dictator.
That Burnham, that we
I'm not wanting to put on our side, but they're going to pay some council.
That has not been the case so far.
Well, I know some of the public really have not officially done it.
Okay, so someone here, this is where the alarms come for. Is this person going to come out and check on these alarms?
And the alarm will be updated.
Okay, also, with that being said, so you said that we're supposed to have to be 24/7, where they're going to see the alarm, right? I also saw a memo from the police that says that.
Are you doing this while I'm here?
I'm sorry.
We don't have dispatchers here,
okay,
which has been the case
of
that the officer
we
I've been wanting to do this for years.
This is a very, very temporary situation.
I know a lot about this village. I worked there for 16 years. I know a lot about this village.
And if we don't make sure that she follows the rules, which is the thing we need to do. We have a facility there. We're not going to leave them unprotected. We're going to follow that.
I understand that.
And this procedure has been created time and time over again.
It's not a debate, it's an understanding. I just want to know that when we have alarm calls at this council right here, at this dispatch center council, where there has not been a dispatcher, who's going to respond to that alarm call for the water check? Okay, so at what point are we going to have someone sitting at this council to notify the person of the alarm call? So as of July 1st, we will have 24/7 dispatch in-house at this council.
I mean, short of a happy dash. Okay. All right.
You ready for me to proceed?
Yeah, proceed, yes.
Doug?
Yes, ma'am, I am.
I'd like to make a motion to approve the hire of Andre Lewis as a temporary certified operator of the pump station for the amount of $800. On a monthly basis.
Yeah, motion approved by Trustee Richardson.
I have another question.
Why don't we just go ahead and finish this topic? Go ahead and
make the motion.
So now we need a second. Second. Put the clerk take the roll.
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner? I have a question. How temporary is this?
Proceed.
Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Greer?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you, motion passed. I mean, temporary, I mean, we don't know. That's some thing that we got to take a look at. Right now, the main thing is that we have to cover.
Is he
going to
answer the alarm calls?
I've already answered that.
You said yes? And how temporary is this?
The next issue is park and recreation.
Nothing.
Whatever we do at these meetings, we're going to try to make sure we be in order. But we always want to be disrespectful. Noise or whatever the case be, we just try to be able to express our way. We cannot let the meeting prolong for the rest of the night, and we will proceed. And sometimes,
we can give an answer to a person tomorrow.
That's acceptable, so if that's the case, then we'll come back. The trustee was assigned a particular committee.
Yes, sir.
And the committee that you was assigned was Park and Recreation. And Trustee Richmond was assigned Public Utilities. And Trustee Cap was assigned Finance. And Trustee Garcia got an Order and Resolution Planning. Public Work got Trustee Claybrook and Public Education, Health, Safety, and Welfare, Trustee Greer. It is fitting and proper for the trustees to follow their own committees. And if they have a comment or something on another committee, then that comment should be made on the time when that committee report is being made. So we shouldn't just jump all over the place.
I'm sorry, sir, you didn't open for discussion. That's why I didn't say anything at that time, because you did not
Then communication, then the morning, then the rest of my system.
Yes.
Then the unfinished business.
Yes, sir. I wanted to read the commendation given to the two officers that recovered two guns off of our strip mall last month. I still have not read that commendation.
Well, first of all, if that would come under the public safety committee, that would not come under your committee. Beyond that, I mean, sometime when these type of things happen, we can't always or should not always bring them to the public right away. And sometimes investigations have to be done, and sometimes we don't want to speak too soon.
This is the fairness that I'm talking about. This is the fairness that the outside HR cannot take care of.
I mean, but every incident cannot be brought to the public.
I understand, but this is the fairness that I'm talking about.
Well, I mean, just like, I mean, some people feel that I like to see a squad car, I mean, all the time. Well, sometimes the police, their car is unmarked. So the thing that the resident won't, they won't say that. You don't necessarily have to know that's the police, because he won't be able to see everything if he's on a squad car. And so we use different techniques.
Well, you talk about safety, but when you say that we have two officers on the street, and you take one of these officers on to come to their own paperwork, and you have to get rid of your dishwasher, and that's community safety there. Now you're taking those officers off the street.
I mean, we're gonna do everything we can to continue to safeguard the village of Burnham. The village of Burnham is not about to fall into Lake Michigan or the Little Cadillac River, so it doesn't have to be safe for anybody and be moving ahead. And is there any new business? I'll ask for a motion to adjourn.
I make a motion to adjourn.
I second.
Motion by Trustee Claybrook, second by Trustee Richardson. Clerk, take the roll.
Trustee Cap?
Yes.
Trustee Bonner?
Yes.
Trustee Greer? Trustee Garcia?
Yes.
Trustee Greer?
Yes.
Trustee Richardson?
Yes.
Trustee Claybrook?
Yes.
Your motion carries. Thank you. Meeting adjourned. Thanks for coming.